Previously, we mentioned that on a Riemannian manifold, we can have many linear connections. But we want to look at those that actually capture the Riemannian geometry. So we want to look at the connections that are actually compatible with the Riemannian metric, and we defined that last time, what that means. These are connections such that the parallel transport they induce are actually isometry. Now we want to actually go a bit further. We want to single out a canonical choice, a unique connection on the Riemannian manifold, right? And we'll call that the Riemannian connection. Unfortunately, or maybe fortunately, I don't know, there are a lot of connections that are compatible with the Riemannian metric. So just requiring compatibility is not enough to cut out a unique connection. We want to add another condition to cut out this unique connection. And how do we figure out which condition to add? The idea is that we want this Riemannian connection to generalize the natural induced connection on M when M is actually a submanifold of Rn. So given the Euclidean connection on Rn, right, how do we define this natural induced connection on a submanifold M of Rn? Let's say x and y are vector fields on M. How would we define this? Well, so first of all, we can extend x and y to be vector field on the whole of Rn. Thus, it makes sense then to take the Euclidean connection, right, of y along the direction of x. Now, this at every point P, this is going to be a tangent vector in the tangent space to Rn at P. But we have a projection map from that each such tangent space, right, to the tangent space to M at P. So the projection of this vector field gives us this vector field over M. This is a vector field of Rn, and now projection of this gives us a vector field over M. We call this the tangential connection. Now, it turns out that this tangential connection on any submanifold of Rn is uniquely determined by two properties. One is that it's compatible with the induced Riemannian connection, and second is that it's symmetric. So what does it mean? So symmetric, for a connection to be symmetric, that means its torsion tensor is zero. Its torsion tensor is defined as follows. Just to say that a connection is symmetric is equivalent to saying that this difference is measured by the Lie bracket. We will explain the intuition for this later when it's relevant, but for now, what is important is that these two conditions uniquely determine the tangential connection on an embedded submanifold of Rn. However, it turns out that being an embedded submanifold of Rn is not such a special condition after all. So by a theorem of John Nash, it turns out that every Riemannian manifold can be realized as a sub-Riemannian manifold of some Euclidean space. Note that we don't just mean that we can embed a Riemannian manifold into some Rn. We are saying something stronger, that we can embed it in such a way that its metric is actually the induced metric on Rn. Now, Nash embedding theorem together with our discussion about the tangential connection means that these two conditions uniquely determine a connection on a Riemannian manifold, which we call the Riemannian connection, or some might call it the Levi-Civitale connection of G. By Nash embedding theorem, this is realized as the tangential connection with respect to some embedding of M as a sub-Riemannian manifold of some Euclidean space. Now, finally, we want to make a remark. We didn't choose this Riemannian connection arbitrarily just so that there is some canonical choice. The reason why the Riemannian connection is so nice, it's because it satisfies some naturality property. Every isometry takes Riemannian connection to Riemannian connection, and it preserves the notions that we can define from the Riemannian connection, for example, the corresponding geodesics, or covariant derivative of vector field along curves, and so on. So that naturality, together with uniqueness, is what makes the Riemannian connection very useful.